Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Pretty Poison Simming, a South African Simmer. So in today's video, it is Wednesday, so we are continuing with the alphabet build challenge. It's where I make a build with the letter of the alphabet. I started from Z, I am now on U already, so I'm working my way back to A. Now with this U shape, I can say I really did struggle a lot with the... It's like the circular curved walls. I struggled so much with it. So I actually ended up having to make like a little second floor by the circular wall section because I was just struggling to get the shapes to stick properly. So with this build, I had in mind a theme at the beginning. As you can see, it's blue. So I was thinking of doing something like under the sea type of blue theme. But after I do the kids' bedrooms and start with the bathroom, I completely change the theme for this build. I make it completely different. So yeah, you guys will see that maybe when I start doing the bathroom, the inside doesn't match the outside. But I do change the outside later on. It's just I changed my mind for the theme of this build, and I think the final product in the end is really pretty. I really love how this build turned out. So yeah, and I also, for this build, I actually made bigger bathrooms because usually I just make a small 2x3 bathroom. So for this build, I actually experimented a little bit with bigger bathrooms, and I think it looks really pretty. So the family I made for this house, or I built this house for this family, right? So it is a couple, and then they have three children. So they have a boy infant. So the house is equipped with infant and toddler equipment, you know, like high chair, potty chair, that kind of stuff. And then they have two teenage daughters. So the one is like all girly, loves pink, cheerleader type vibes. And the other one is more like a bit of a gothic, mystical type of girl. She likes that kind of stuff. I think she's gonna be a... like, let's say a jewelry maker, a crystal creator, you know? So I did also put some stuff like that in the house that she can do. Now, this house overall has a lot of skill building items. And for the part in the middle of the U, I made it like an activity courtyard type of vibe. But there's also barbecue and a... what is that? A swimming pool? I mean, what is that? It's a swimming pool. So this house also has a swimming pool. So that's really awesome. So now I'm working on the boy infant's room. So I tried to put a lot of clouds and stuff on the walls just to make it look cute and decorative. So you'll see here by the girly bedroom, I used this prom wall curtains with the balloons from the high school years back. I just thought it fits so perfect in this room, like it just really pieced together so well. And then this is the gothic girl, mystical girl bedroom. So I think it's also pretty cute though. You'll see she has the pride flag and she has a cute little kitty rug by the door. So it doesn't necessarily just have to be mystical and goth type of vibes. She does have a bit of other stuff. But yeah, I quite like how this room actually turned out. I love it. I also gave her a TV so she can like chill in bed and watch TV. I don't think I gave the pink bedroom a TV though. But it's fine, you know, she'll focus on her cheerleading. So then yeah, I actually moved the bed to the side of the wall so that it could make more space for me to put stuff in the room. So both rooms I use this cute little bench, so if they have friends over, they can like sit on the bench in their room if they, you know, don't want to chill with the rest of the family or whatever the case is. So now I'm just like placing out the clutter for these three rooms that I might want to use. I don't necessarily use all the clutter I placed out, but yeah, I do use a lot of it. So starting off with the gothic mystical room, just put some stuff. I even put a little backpack there. She has a suitcase, a basket with pillows and blankets. She bought new trainer shoes, so there's a box of shoes there, and some wall art for her as well. I think this is my favorite room in the house, is this mystical goth room. And then for the pink room, I put some starry lights on the walls and this pink, what is it? It's like a bird ornament. I think you put it outside in the garden though, but I just felt like, you know what? It will fit in this room, so let's give it a shot. And I actually like this statue in the room. It looks pretty cool. And then this box I put on the bed, I thought it was the friendship bracelet box. I didn't read it. And then I was like, but that's a spanner. That doesn't look right. So then I had to first go look for the friendship bracelet making kit. But then I did find it and I put it on her bed. She looks like that type. She'll make her sister a friendship bracelet. And then just some stuff for the infant room. I didn't put too much clutter in this room though, because I feel like as he ages up, this room is anyways going to... I don't know if you guys do that, but as he ages up, then you're gonna kind of need to adapt his room to his new age. So, you know, if he becomes a toddler, you're gonna need to put a toddler bed and stuff like that. So I don't want to put too much clutter if it's anyways gonna get changed. And as you can see, these are the new vibes I'm gonna give the house, you know, with the cement wall and the brick wall. I just, when I did this bathroom, it like, this idea sparked in my mind and I was like, I recently made a bedroom with this kind of vibes and I really loved it. And I've never done a build like that, like a whole build, so that is then what I did, yeah, something a bit different to my usual builds. So yeah, for the bathrooms, I wanted to give it a shower and a bathtub, which I think is really cool. I like having both options. So that is what I did. Yeah, it's very spacious, the bathroom. I'm not used to that. I'm used to tiny bathrooms. So this was a bit... I had to think carefully like how to clutter it up, but I think it looks really good in the end. So as you can see, this is more kind of the kids' bathroom. We have the little potty chair there for the poor toddler. The lights where I placed it, I had to move it because it was my son didn't want to use the bath or shower. It's like, hello, the lights are in the way, I can't get up the step. It's like, what the hell, man, you can just crouch. Any case, so I did have to move that. And then this is the other bathroom. This is like the parents' bathroom. It's a bit slimmer, as you can see, but I generally use the same type of furniture. Now, I did play test this, as you know I always do, and the toilet and the basin, even though it's like on one block, it does still work and is functional. It's just a bit weird with the male sim, because when he stands and pees, he doesn't stand on the raised part, he stands on the lower part. So it's a bit funny, but otherwise, look-wise, it is perfect and it does work, it is functional, they can use the bathroom facilities. So this will be the main bedroom for the parents. I also put a platform in this room, so then the area where their bed is a bit higher. I used a lot of industrial loft kit furniture in this build, which I really love. The industrial loft kit furniture is amazing. And so the parents basically just have the bed, they have the couch there that they can chill on, they have the mirror from high school years, which is beautiful in white. The room doesn't have a lot of stuff. Like, I kind of kept it neat, you know. I didn't want to make it messy and dear my car, so I just threw in Afrikaans word there without thinking. I'm sorry, I meant messy. I was focusing on my cat now because my cat's crying by the door. She wants to go outside, but she could just wait a little bit. When I'm done, I'll let her out. Okay, so now I'm doing the rest of the house. I'm just like figuring out what colors I want the walls. And then I like this wooden flooring color. I can't remember from which kit it is or pack, but I really love this. Then for the kitchen, I use base game counters because the industrial loft didn't come with counters. But I felt like these counters actually fit the vibe. And then I decided to make it white because the browner colors, it like blends too much with the floor of this house. Now, one thing to note here with these curved wall sections is it like makes me struggle to select items that is in that area. Like, even when playing and I want to use the kitchen and stuff, or like the dining table, I struggle to be able to select it, even though my mouse is on the item. So I did find that if you guys play with this, you should just put down all the walls, make it flat. Then you can select the items without a problem. But if you do like half the walls up or all the walls up, then it creates a problem. I don't know why, it's a Sims bug, which it really annoys me and it baffles my mind that it's still a problem, because yeah, it's a problem. But anyways, the workaround is just lower all the walls, then you can access the items. So I usually play with like half walls up or all the walls up, because I like to see how the whole house looks, because it's so pretty. So that's why I like playing with the walls up. So then what I do when I can't access a certain item because of the curved walls, then I just lower it quickly, access the item and put the walls back up. It can be a bit annoying, I know, but it's a workaround for the curved walls. So yeah, this is the kitchen, living room slash, what can you call that, like a study hallway type vibes. They even have a bar so they can have drinks. Like, I'm telling you guys, this house has everything. So yeah, by the parents' bathroom, I also put the like a little laundry section. Oh, and this house has a garage, but we will do that at the end. So I think overall in this house, I put 3 of those little infant play pen type thingies where they lie on the square thingy and it has the stuff hanging over them, you know, where they do tummy time and that kind of stuff. I forgot its name right now, but anyways, I put 3 in the house. So I mean, there's a lot of stuff to do for all ages in this family. They also have a fireplace. They have a small TV though, but it has a gaming console, it has a radio and everything. So now we are upstairs, which is, this is like the skills and hobby room, and then I put some sports equipment there outside. So in this hobby room we have the chess table, we have the jewelry maker station, we have 2 easels, and then I, even though there isn't a child currently in the house, the infant is gonna grow up, so I already put a children's arts and craft table there. And what else did I put there? I put another infant playpen there, you can see that, and a couch just so they can like chill or whatever. Oh yeah, that's what I put there. I put the activity table so they can maybe build some puzzles and hang it on the wall and stuff like that. So now I'm just looking for some clutter that I could put here, put some stuff for the jewelry maker. I haven't really like furnished the house with the Crystal Creations back yet, besides using the beautiful wallpaper. But yeah, I put some furniture there to try and see how it looks. And then there's just like some toys as well, because like maybe while the family is doing their hobby stuff, then the infant can also just chill and play there, you know. You don't want to leave them alone downstairs or something. So yeah. And this is then the garage. Nothing special really for the garage. It has a vehicle. I put another vehicle outside. Since it's a family, you want to have a family car as well. And then I do some terrain paint. Decided to make it like this. I don't know, is it like gravel or cement or what? But yeah, I make the building outside now also white, just to match the inside. So I like scratch the whole blue idea. So I think that actually looks better. And then for this part I made the pool. I also put like a little area where they can lounge on the, what would you call that now, the sunbeds. So this has a little basketball hoop, there's a punch bag, some gym equipment, I even can do like meditation and yoga. And then also some cheerleading dance mats. I put 2 for if both the teenagers wanna practice cheerleading, but I don't know. But there is a barbecue as well and some seating area. Also made a little area with a telescope. I felt like that will be also a nice touch. And then I also do add a table with a tea set. I love using the tea set, so I also add that in the active courtyard. And of course some lights on the pool. I love using these dine out lights on the pool, it's so pretty. And then I put a few stepping stones. I did alter the build a bit to make sure you can get from the active courtyard to the stargazing area without having to go out the front door. You know, you can go through the back as well, so it is a bit quicker. And then I also just laid out where I'm gonna put the garden, which I will get to in a minute. So this is where I put the tea set, so they can also like just have a little tea party outside. And yeah, now I'm just finishing off my build with some landscaping. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please do let me know in the comments what you think. It's fully functional, playtested, available on my gallery, and no CC was used. Hope you guys like it, give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Poison out.